Hey guys, welcome to RealMelTan. In this episode, we're going to take a look at MSI's newest top-of-the-line AIO, the MEG S360. Is this AIO really worth its hefty price tag? Let's find out. The MEG S360 is MSI's newest top-of-the-line AIO with a thick 360mm radiator, 3 Gale P12 fans and a very powerful pump. And of course, similar to its beefy cousin, the K360, it comes with a very pretty LCD screen to show off the performance numbers. This time, it's upgraded to 2.4-inch, but more on that later, so make sure to stay till the end of the video for that. But before we get to its features, we know what you want, so let's go on to how well it performs. Similar to our Fractal Design Lumen S24 video that we have done, we're going to cool a Ryzen 9 5900X plus MSI X570 Unify inside our Fantex Lenko 2 mesh. As for its competitor, because we don't have the K360, we're going to bring out the Big Daddy Meme AIO NZXT's Quicken Z73. At idle, the MSI S360 averages at 44.2 degrees C, peaking at 46.5. The Quicken has a lower average at 40.1, but peaks at a higher 63.8 degrees. To push these AIOs, first we have ADA 64. The S360 averages at 66.1 degrees and peaks at 76.1. The Z73 has a lower average at 60 degrees, but peaks the same at 76 degrees. Next, we have Cinebench R23. The S360 averages at 67.2 and peaks at 76.1. The Kraken Z73, on the other hand, averages lower at 53.1 and peaks at 72.1. As for sound levels, man, it's really, really, really loud. Why? To make this a fair test, we have set the front and intake fans to run at 100% load when the system reaches 80 degrees. Likewise, radiator fans also run at 100% when the system reaches 70 degrees. I know these are meant to be silent Gale P12 fans, so if this is too noisy for you, you can always go to your default fan curves in your BIOS. You can set the radiator fans to run at low RPM when the system is below 80 degrees. But do take note that the fans will spin out automatically when the system is above 80 degrees. If you're wondering, these fans run at 2000 RPM, but they are nowhere as loud as my exhaust and intake fans when they are running at full load. FYI, because there's only one exhaust fan, it is the loudest because it's doing the most work to push the heat out of the system. So now let's go on to some things that we like and some things that we may not like about the AIO. First, compared to other AIOs that we have seen, the S360 uses longer radiator case mounting screws. Because of the longer screw threads, you can hand screw first before you use your screwdriver to screw the rest in. Number 2, similar to the Kraken Z73, the S360 uses the 4-prongs design method to mount your water block. If you are a first-time builder, the 4-prong system is a lot easier to mount than the latch system that we see on the Lumen S24. Just note, if you are using an AMD Ryzen CPU like us, make sure to swap out the Intel bracket for the AMD bracket. Which brings us to point number 3, the S360 uses the AsaTech mounting design. Swapping out the mounting bracket is very easy, just turn and pull out the bracket that you don't need, pull in the new bracket you need and lock it back in. Pro number 4, as mentioned earlier, the S360 uses silent Gale P12 fans. They are relatively silent even at full load, and you can set them to run at low speeds below 80 degrees. Don't worry, your CPU will actually run fine even at such temperatures. If you worry that it's too hot, you can follow us. Just set your intake and your front fans to run at full 100% load and let them do all the work. But it is really, really, really loud. And the last pro, okay, not really a pro, but I quote from the box. Compatibility with Intel's socket LGA1700. And we also have the mounting bracket to actually prove it. I cannot say which CPU is going to support, but I'm sure you guys know. So make sure to smash the subscribe button if you want to see the magic happen. Alright, time for the cons. Number 1, there are quite a few wires coming out of the water block. There's SATA power, there's the USB for the LCD screen, the fan splitter as well as the CPU fan wire. And also don't forget the 2 tubings from the radiator. This may cause a problem for you if you are a wire management guru or you're a first time PC builder. Anyway, if you are a first time PC builder, I don't know why you're spending so much money on a high-end AIO like this, but yeah, that's up to you. And also, you have to take into consideration that you have to put the LCD cover back when you're done with the wire management. I do not know what's the best way to wire management all these wires, but I usually like to test mount the cool water block first before I actually mount the water block fully. I will hide the SATA power, the fan splitter, as well as the CPU fan behind the water block, route the USB cable to the other side, to the bottom of the case, so that I can mount it on the USB header on the motherboard. With that, I can actually easily put back the LCD cover on top of the LCD screen. Number 2, the Gale P12 fans are not RGB. But hell, are there actually fans for MSI that are RGB? I think MSI probably stuck with their mantra. It's actually better to design high quality fans than try to stick some RGB on the fans. This is always very, very welcome. I mean, like, how much RGB do you actually need? Number 3, this is a mixed bag for us. The MSI S360 comes with a water block fan to cool the VRMs, M.2 SSD, as well as the surrounding components. This is a great option to have, because unlike air coolers, which also remove heat around the socket, there's only one direction for heat to travel within AIOs, which is up and out. Some heat may be trapped around the area below the socket and around the M.2 area. Now, with this AIO, you can be sure your VRMs and M.2 will be cool because of the water block fan. But that said, the water block fan tends to run at very high RPMs, especially during load. It runs at above 3000 RPM. It can create a lot of noise and it can be very irritating to some people. Of course, you can actually reduce the fan speeds in MSI Center. You can set it to run similar to how you run for your radiator fans. The water block fan may also be an additional point of failure in conjunction with your pump. Okay, a bit on the installation. Since the pump is now on the water block, we recommend that you top mount your AIO. You can try to front mount or even bottom mount your radiator, but we do not recommend you to do so, because the flow may not be right and you may actually develop more bubbles inside your water block. If you do not believe what I say, make sure to check out Gamer Nexus's video on AIO orientation again. To wire up your AIO, you can daisy chain your radiator fans using the fan splitter, connect SATA power to your SATA port on your PSU, connect the CPU fan wire onto your CPU header on your motherboard, connect the USB on your provided USB header on your motherboard. As for the LCD screen on the water block, we're going to go to MSI Center. I will not talk too much about MSI Center, but basically you can use your LCD screen to display numbers such as CPU temps, coolant temps, and GPU usage. I currently have the LCD displaying the CPU temps, pump fan, radiator fan, as well as water block fan speeds. You can also show the current time on your system or even put out a very cool GIF. But we have some issues with the GIF. You can see from video, Neon Cat and the character for Among Us looks very, very choppy. We believe that it may be a controller software issue for MSI Center. I will update you guys when I get an update for MSI. And yes, if you also forget to plug in a component, the LCD screen will inform you. So now let's go on to the big question. Which AIO will we actually choose? Honestly, both AIOs are very expensive, but if I have to choose one, I will go with the Kraken for now. For now. The Kraken C73 performs slightly better than this guy in AR64 and Cinebench R23. Both AIOs, as you can see, are very reliant on the software that's provided. But of course, do not put down the MSI S360 for now. We believe that since the MSI Center is still new, there's still a lot of work to be done for the software. Once MSI fixes the software on the MSI Center, we believe that the S360 will perform a lot better. NZXT's CAM software has been around for many, many years, so that's why it's very stable and it runs as well as how it's supposed to be for top-of-the-line AIO. That's it for the hefty price tag, not just paying for performance, but also for the looks. You can actually get similar performance from a plain-looking EK360 AIO. Alright, this is it. Man, this is such a tough video to do. If you like this video, which I hope you do, make sure to give me a very big thumbs up. And in the meantime, you can also watch our review of the Lumen S24 below. I hope to see you next episode, and with that, I say goodbye to you.